we want to write each radical expression using rational exponents. To do this in radical form, we need to identify the index of the radical, which will be the denominator of the rational exponent, and then the exponent in radical form, which can be outside the radical or underneath the radical, which will be the numerator of the rational exponent. So for square root 5, we need to recognize that the index is 2, and the exponent on the 5 would be 1. And since the index is 2, and the exponent is 1, we can rewrite this as 5 to the power of 1/2. For the cube root of 7, since the index is 3, and the exponent on the 7 is 1, this is equal to 7 raised to the power of 1/3. So taking the square root of something is the same as raising it to the 1/2 power, and taking the cube root of something is the same as raising it to the 1/3 power. And for the fifth root of x to the second, again the index is 5, the exponent is 2, so this is equal to x raised to the 2/5 power. And then for the last example, we have the cube root of x to the 6, y to the 8th. There are a couple ways of showing this, but notice how the index is 3, and we have x raised to the 6th and y raised to the 8th. So this is equal to x to the power of 6/3 and y to the power of 8/3. But notice how 6/3 simplifies to 2, so we can write this as x to the second, y to the 8/3. Another way to show this would be to write the radicand of x to the 6th, y to the 8th, raised to the 1/3 power, because remember, taking the cube root of something is the same as raising it to the 1/3 power, as we saw from this example. And now notice we have powers raised to powers, so we multiply the exponents. So we'd have x to the power of 6 times 1/3, which is 2, and y to the power of 8 times 1/3, which is 8/3. So we can see the result would be the same. We'll take a look at some more examples involving rational exponents in the next few videos.